All right, we are going to find the area of this circle, and we have the polar function here. R is equal to sine theta minus square root of 3 times cosine theta. Well, right here, it looks like it's a starting, but if you think about it, if theta is equal to 0, well, sine theta is equal to 0, and then cosine theta is equal to 1. So when theta is equal to 0, in fact, R will be equal to negative square root of 3. So technically, when theta is equal to 0, once you're looking at this direction, you're actually going to here, right? So if you just let theta 1 to be 0, you are actually going to start here. And then you just have to rotate back here. And that's how you find the theta 1 and theta 2. But in my opinion, let's just go ahead and do this. Let's start right here. And remember, right here, this is where R is equal to 0. We have to solve this equation. So let's just put that down. So let me just write down, we have the sine theta minus square root of 3 cosine theta, and then we are going to set this to be 0. And we just have to find out the first two angles that they are going to give us R is equal to 0. And that will be our theta 1 and theta 2. So that's the strategy for solving this question. All right, so let's move this to the other side, and we are talking about sine theta being equal to square root of 3 cosine theta, and divide both sides by cosine theta, we end up with tangent theta equals square root of 3. Well, tangent of what angle will give you square root of 3? If you think about it right here on the unit circle, or maybe you can just draw the reference triangle. Tangent is what? It's opposite over adjacent, so it looks like this. This is square root of 3, and this is equal to 1. And then we have actually a 30-60-90 special right triangle, and this right here being the 60 degrees. So this right here is actually pi over 3, isn't it? Great. And then we will also have another situation that tangent is equal to square root of 3, namely this place right here. So this right here is negative square root of 3, and this is negative 1. This little angle is still pi over 3, but we will have to go from here to here. So that's pi plus pi over 3, and we are talking about 4 pi over 3. So here we have it, theta 1, theta 2, that's all. Try not to be too complicated, because in fact you can use other angles, but this and that will do the work. All right, so remember the formula. The area is equal to the integral from theta 1 to theta 2. Theta 1 is pi over 3, while theta 2 is 4 pi over 3. And then the inside is 1 half, and you open the parentheses, and you square whatever we need. And then we have the d theta, and the inside is just you put the function here, which we have the sine theta, and then minus square root of 3, cosine theta. And I'm going to leave the computation for you guys. This right here is the setup. So you have to figure out what the numerical value for this integral is. And that's it.